Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Heather Sells. President Obama is unveiling his revised blueprint for health care reform today. It is expected to include a few Republican proposals. While that's unlikely to win any GOP support, it might persuade some reluctant Democrats to sign on. Charlene Israel has more from the newsroom.
The president wants Congress to pass health care reform legislation before he travels to Asia later this month. Obama's retooled plan includes some Republican ideas from last week's health summit, like investigating health care providers for fraud and reforming medical malpractice laws. Democrats have been trying to line up enough votes for passage in the House. In the Senate, they were prepared to use a controversial procedure called reconciliation to bypass a Republican filibuster. It would allow approval by a simple majority vote.
Our legislation will have legislation that is affordable for the middle class and holds the insurance company accountable in doing so.
The reconciliation idea has raised charges of partisanship. The president argues his health care overhaul will reduce the federal deficit, so he thinks it's an acceptable tactic. But Republicans say most Americans don't support the overhaul, and reconciliation is only being used to ram the bill through Congress.
It won't work. It won't work because it was never designed for that kind of significant legislation.
If more money and more government were the answer, we would have fixed health care a long time ago.
Republicans contend the plan is too expensive and will only add to America's ballooning budget deficits.
We need to start over. That's what the American people want us to do.
Even with a few Republican ideas included in the plan, Republican opposition is expected to be unanimous, setting up a pivotal issue for the November congressional elections. Reporting from the newsroom, I'm Charlene Israel.
Thanks, Charlene. The Supreme Court is refusing to intervene in Washington, D.C.'s new gay marriage law. That law goes into effect today. Opponents of same-sex marriage had argued to Chief Justice Roberts that voters should be allowed to have a say in this issue. Local courts had rejected that argument, and Roberts deferred to them, calling it a local matter. Today is the first day that same-sex couples can apply for marriage licenses in D.C., but they'll still have to wait 3 business days to receive them and exchange vows. Bishop Harry Jackson of the High Impact Leadership Coalition helped lead the fight against legalizing gay marriage in the district. He joins us now. Bishop Jackson, you and other pastors fought long and hard to prevent today from happening. Why did this effort fall short?
Well, just like in other states, we deal with the fact that if the courts don't really intervene and let the people have their voices, or if legislators act on their own and don't confer with the people, then you wind up with things that really aren't the best and really don't go with the opinions and the heartfelt desires of the community.
Were you surprised that the Supreme Court, that Chief Justice Roberts ruled the way that he did?
Well, Heather, I was, because first, I was shocked that it got there. I was so grateful. It was the answer to prayer. But he on his own said, hey, it's a local matter. And I think he's wrong on this, in that it directly challenges the Defense of Marriage Act and the 31 marriage amendments that have been passed around the country. And this is going to be the beginning of a major national fight to redefine marriage.
Now, Bishop, from what you've seen, the way this has played out in D.C., do you think Christians are going to have to change their tactics, the way they engage the culture on this issue?
Wow, I'm so glad you asked that question. I think we will. What's happened is a very small minority has lobbied, has voted, has given money to campaigns, and therefore they control many capital cities on these issues. If Christians would get motivated and involved in the areas where we're concerned about, Heather, we can change America for good and make a major, major reformation in our day.
Okay, and tell us about the black community in D.C., because I know that that was really the focus of both sides going after that community, trying to persuade it. Where do you think the black community in D.C. stands on this issue?
Well, it's very clear by Washington Post poll, which I think is a little biased, but it clearly most blacks are not for gay marriage. NPR and others have tried to say that this is a major shift. But what has happened is a few visible blacks, small minority, have come out ministers and are beginning to waver in terms of their biblical orthodoxy. But nationwide, African Americans are against gay marriage. Locally, we all understand if you redefine marriage, you further endanger our very, very challenged families at this time.
All right. And I know you've got another court date coming up, so the battle continues and we'll continue to keep watching it. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Pray for us. Thanks for having me.
The Supreme Court is not getting involved with a Ten Commandments battle in Oklahoma. The High Court left in place a lower court's decision to remove a Ten Commandments monument from government property. That court ruled the monument unconstitutional. The Supreme Court says determining whether the Ten Commandments can be displayed on government property is a case-by-case affair. Well, the High Court is not weighing in on gay marriage or the Ten Commandments. The justices are deciding if states or cities can keep law-abiding citizens from owning guns. A 28-year-old ban on handguns in Chicago is at the center of this case. Paul Strand has more on Tuesday's hearing from the Supreme Court.
Both those who believe in strict gun control and unfettered gun rights descended on the Supreme Court to argue whether the Second Amendment forbids any local jurisdiction from banning gun ownership. Some 90 million Americans own 200 million guns. That's why it's such a big deal whenever the Supreme Court takes up a gun case, especially one like this that deals with the very fundamental issue of whether citizens have a right to own and bear firearms. The court ruled 20 months ago the citizens of Washington, D.C. have that right. Those who want to strike down Chicago's handgun ban think this case could extend the same right across the country.
The court is going to decide, hopefully, that people in the United States enjoy all of their Second Amendment rights, not some diluted, some watered down, some shadow version of the right to keep and bear arms.
While gun control advocate Paul Helmke is betting the court will strike down Chicago's ban, he believes the justices will back some restrictions on gun owners.
With 30,000 people killed every year in this country with guns, 80,000 people injured every year in this country with guns, elected officials need to have some choices that they can make to reduce crime and violence in their communities.
But Alan Gura is betting an America where all law-abiding citizens can legally defend themselves with guns will reduce crime.
In the end of the day, I think we're going to have a lot more safety in America and a lot more freedom.
This case, McDonald versus City of Chicago, is named for this man, 76-year-old Otis McDonald. He's fighting Chicago's ban because he's had it with being a defenseless victim of crime in his own home over and over.
I was threatened, broken into at least three times.
And he says the only people hurt by Chicago's handgun ban are law-abiding citizens. The lawbreakers just go ahead and get guns anyway. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from the Supreme Court.
Thanks, Paul. The Army has discharged four Muslim soldiers. A fifth has been removed from active duty. These are the same soldiers who were investigated for allegedly plotting to poison the food at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. But sources close to the investigation say the men did not make any effort to poison food and that allegations about their disloyalty were inaccurate. One congressman says the men have actually been let go because they were stealing from other soldiers. But CBN News terrorism analyst Eric Stackelbeck says there are more serious concerns that aren't being talked about in public.
An intelligence source very close to this investigation at Fort Jackson told me that they were looking into ties between the Fort Jackson Five and the five young Muslims from the Washington, D.C. area who were arrested around Christmas time, traveling to Pakistan to wage jihad against U.S. troops there.
And we'll keep you posted on this case as more details emerge. Texas Governor Rick Perry took a step forward toward winning his third term by defeating Senator Kay Bailey Hutchison in Tuesday's Republican primary. Political analysts credit the governor with tapping into anti-Washington sentiment, slamming the federal government for spending, job losses, and the health care debate. Perry will face former Houston Mayor Bill White in November. White, known as a calm consensus builder, easily defeated six opponents to win the Democratic primary. 2,000 employees of the Transportation Department are going back to work today. President Obama has signed a spending measure that restores funding for highway projects. It also extends unemployment benefits for the longtime jobless. The $10 billion measure had been held up in the Senate by Kentucky's Jim Bunning. Bunning said the bill adds to the federal deficit and that Congress should have made budget cuts to pay for it. He dropped his objection last night. The U.S. Postal Service wants to stop delivering the mail on Saturdays. It is part of a cost-cutting proposal from the Postmaster General. He is also recommending closing some post offices and teaming up with private retail outlets. Last year, the post office lost $7 billion. Estimates show it will lose $238 billion over the next decade.
The projections going forward are not bright. We are not going to be able to freeze our labor rates. We're not going to be able to freeze our costs for fuel and facilities and vehicles. We're hoping that the American public will embrace these changes.
This downturn in business is being blamed on the growing number of people paying bills online and competition from private companies like FedEx and UPS. The postmaster says that without his proposed changes, the federal mail service will not survive. The House Majority Leader says tax hikes are needed to bring down the deficit. Democrat Steny Hoyer says the only way to cut the government's $12 trillion debt is to raise taxes and cut spending. That would go against President Obama's promise not to raise taxes on those making less than $250,000 a year. Republicans say tax increases should be off the table. Instead, they say cutting taxes and government spending would boost the economy and lower the debt. Coming up, could the U.S. be next? How the West Coast is preparing for a major earthquake.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord, God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for only $24.99.
Here I am to worship. Here I am.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on three CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Devastated villagers on Chile's coast are still waiting for relief to arrive. The tsunami that followed Saturday's earthquake washed away fishing boats and homes up to 2 miles inland. Food and water are scarce, and villagers are complaining that government help is slow in coming. Meantime, in the hard-hit city of Concepcion, signs of normal activity are returning. The government is giving out food and water, and some gas stations are reopening. Residents also attended an improvised mass outside this church. The government has now revised the death toll to 796. Well, the huge earthquake in Chile has emergency officials in the U.S. taking inventory. They want to know how serious the risk is for a major quake and tsunami to strike the West Coast and how prepared Americans would be. Mark Martin has the story.
If a major earthquake hit off the coast of Portland, Oregon, experts say tall buildings would shake violently and winds could carry broken glass as far as a half mile away. They also say, like what happened in Chile, rubble would be everywhere and there would be casualties. Portland resident Kinsey Horn and her family are not taking any chances.
Yeah, in grade school and high school, they always told us to make an earthquake kit. So I have one in my car and one in my house, and my parents have them in their houses.
According to Oregon state geologist, a large earthquake like the one that devastated Chile will happen near Portland.
We're about 75 miles out where the subduction zone is to the coast. And then, of course, it's only another 50, 70 miles into Portland.
Geologists found earthquake hazards across the region, including old bridges and hundreds of buildings put up before nationwide seismic regulations that went into effect in 1971.
Unfortunately for us, it's an uphill battle because people don't really pay attention to the fact that it can happen here.
In California, there's about 350,000 people that would be impacted if there was a major tsunami.
Emergency officials in California have experienced numerous earthquakes, but a tsunami is a different story. However, the state's emergency management agency says its tsunami warning system worked much better this time. California was criticized back in 2006 for its lack of coordination when an earthquake rattled Japan.
We were pleased with the ability to be able to immediately connect with all the counties affected and be able to provide them the information and updates.
The Sacramento Operations Center had even mapped out where the big waves might occur, with Pismo Beach having the most potential for destruction, surges possibly reaching 9 feet. Fortunately, the California coast never saw the big destructive waves this week. So whether it's a tsunami or earthquake or both, it appears emergency leaders on the West Coast are taking preparations seriously. Mark Martin, CBN News.
The United Nations Climate Change Panel may have to change its claim that global warming has led to more hurricanes and tropical storms in recent years. The London Times quotes researchers who say the rise in the number of hurricanes since 1995 was simply part of natural cycles, and all of them were followed by a decline in the number of hurricanes. The research goes on to suggest that in the decades ahead, global warming could actually reduce the number of tropical storms by up to 34%. The Reverend Billy Graham may have retired from preaching, but he's still living a very productive life. The 91-year-old evangelist continues to write books and provide spiritual counseling. Recently, he spoke on the phone with President Obama and former President George W. Bush. He was also visited by former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin. His son Franklin said that Reverend Graham's glib advice is don't get old. Up next, an early morning raid on an underground church in China is felt halfway around the world. Now one daughter of imprisoned Christians is speaking out.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived. To stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
A religious lawsuit in a Tennessee school district has been settled. This Cheatham County School Board reached an agreement after a lawsuit by the American Civil Liberties Union of Tennessee. The board agreed that religion in the school can be student-led, but not compulsory. School officials are also barred from citing the Bible or other sacred texts as authority for historical or scientific fact. A Chinese seminary student in the U.S. is asking Christians around the world to help free her parents from prison. They were arrested after a recent crackdown against a house church movement. Gary Lane has that story.
From China to America, separated from family.
My dad cried because he really missed me. He don't want me to go to the university. That's too far from home, so he cannot see me.
7,000 miles from home, Chinese student Esther Yang Su was attending seminary in the United States when she learned that her parents had been arrested in the middle of the night.
For me, it's no sense. They took them away and destroyed the church.
In her first television interview since that incident, Esther told CBN News she often cries for her parents.
I'm worried about them be physical beaten or be hurt. I don't want that happen to them. And I also hope them they can have food to eat and they can sleep with warm. Because the north part in China is really cold in winter.
Esther's father, Yang Xuan, and mother, Yang Kaizhen, were among those leading the unregistered Linfen Fushan Church in China's Shaanxi province. Before dawn on September 13, 2009, a crowd of 400 police and other officials raided the church as Christians slept at the church construction site. Some were beaten. At least 30 were injured. 10 church leaders were arrested. Bob Fu is founder and president of China Aid Association, a Texas-based ministry that helps persecuted Chinese Christians.
This church is an evangelical house church with about 50,000 members. And it actually is part of the heritage church from the first of the China Inland Mission. Actually, Linfen is known all over China as the Chinese house church's liberation zone to describe how impactful and influential of this church has been in this area.
And perhaps that's why Chinese government officials felt threatened, felt they had to crack down.
Government officials charged the Linfen pastors with unlawfully occupying agricultural land and gathering to disturb the traffic order.
When they were brought to trial last November, they were fined and given prison sentences ranging from 2 to 7 years. Esther's mother, Kaizhen, received 2 years Lao Gai. That's re-education through labor. Her father, Xuan, received 3.5 years imprisonment. Gordon Chang is a China analyst with Forbes magazine. He says the government is fighting a losing battle against the church in China.
The underground churches, those that are completely considered to be illegal, and the regime tries to stamp them out, but they can't because there are just so many people. And so basically the Communist Party is creating enemies for itself, because in this struggle we can see that faith is so much stronger than the government.
Esther says she believes her father's faith is being strengthened through this experience.
For him, it's encouraging. It's a test from God in order to make us stronger or more love to the God.
While Esther's passion has been renewed, she still misses her parents. She's upset her family could not be together this year to celebrate the spring festival, the Chinese New Year.
And I also cannot hear their voice. I even don't know where they are now. So when I think about this, I'm really sad. I'm really upset.
Tom White is executive director of the Voice of the Martyrs.
She's still pretty torn up about it, but her faith remains strong. She sees the larger picture. I think there's a type of joy you can have even while you're grieving. It's that greater sense that we are immortal in Christ. The church will not lose.
Esther has written a letter of appeal asking the international community to intercede for religious prisoners in China.
We have a big family in the Lord. Pray for them. God still loves them, even they are in the prison.
Gary Lane, CBN News.
And we'll be right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new dos. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Her friends say she may be the oldest resident living in Chicago. Meet Ethel Darden of Montgomery Place in the Hyde Park neighborhood. Mrs. Darden recently celebrated her 110th birthday with family and friends. She was born back in 1900 in Dallas, Texas, and is one of the oldest African Americans still living in the U.S. She says she remains very active in her church and even voted in the recent election in Chicago. Well, finally today, it is a sport for people who thought life had taken them out of the game. Tennessee is home to one of the best power wheelchair soccer teams in the U.S. They're called the Chattanooga Speeders, and they are giving disabled soccer enthusiasts a chance to compete.
He has really flourished since he started playing. It's really brought out a competitive side in him and some self-confidence.
This is an outlet for a part of me that is normally cut off.
This year, the Speeders hope to raise awareness and build sponsors to keep the ball rolling. Well, that's all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at CBNNews.com. And you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
Yeah, buddy.
How many nickels are in a dollar?
There are 20 nickels in a dollar.
How do birds fly? Does milk really make my bones stronger?
Yeah.
Daddy, when we die, will we go to heaven?
Do you have the answer to life's biggest question? Call the 700 Club. We'll help you find answers to the important questions life brings your way.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just two easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.